I password protect a folder. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question, very simple. Can I put a password on a folder so that only I can see its contents? Yes and no, and probably not the way you think. I know, it's confusing. Let's walk through what those alternatives are, and I'll show you what I end up doing myself. So the Windows way, Windows actually does have a facility built in to protect files and folders. And I'm actually not talking about BitLocker. This is a case where you can actually set permissions on folders that restrict access to specific accounts on your machine. So a folder that you restrict, for example, only to your login account, cannot be accessed by any other accounts on that machine except for the administrator account. Unfortunately, that doesn't protect you from somebody who's walking up to your machine while you're using it or while you've stepped away from it if you're logged in, right? If you're logged in, by definition, your account has access. But it is one way. And as a side note, this is why NTFS is required. NTFS file system for your system drive is required because it's the file system that actually supports this level of permissions and security. So that's not quite good enough. For example, it's very possible that, especially if you don't have BitLocker turned on, somebody could steal the hard drive and look at it, or they could boot another operating system and look at it. So what's the right thing to do? Well, the fact that I mentioned BitLocker is kind of a clue, because encryption is the next layer, but it's not using Windows encryption. There are two solutions that I suggest you consider. The closest thing to actually encrypting a folder or a USB thumb drive or whatever is to use VeraCrypt. VeraCrypt allows you to create a vault. That vault just looks like a file on your system. It's full of encrypted data, so just looking at that file tells the user or whoever's looking at it nothing. But when you create an encrypted vault, you also give it a passphrase. And when you then mount that vault using the correct passphrase, what happens is the contents of that encrypted vault appear in their unencrypted form as another drive on your system. And you can then just read and write to that drive all you want to, and all of that information is then saved physically in the encrypted file. Once you unmount it, then it's fine. It's just encrypted data that nobody has access to. It's restricted to you because only you know the passphrase. So that's one recommendation. Now, the issue with VeraCrypt is that that vault is one file. And what that means is that if any little thing in that file changes, then the entire file appears to have changed. The entire vault appears to have changed looking at it from the outside. What that means then is that backup programs and, more interestingly, cloud synchronization programs will basically need to update that entire vault, which might be the size of your thumb drive or the size of something large. They'll need to update the entire thing because, well, it's encrypted, so they don't know what's changed. So they have to assume the entire thing has changed, and therefore they have to upload or backup or do whatever to the entire thing. That's where a tool like Cryptomator comes in. Cryptomator is essentially the same idea. You mount, in this case, a folder in Cryptomator, and by providing the correct passphrase, instead of creating a separate file, a single file that contains everything, Cryptomator encrypts files individually. They're actually stored, encrypted on your hard drive, but individually. So that if a file changes, you've updated a file that in your Cryptomator vault, then a small part of the encrypted data changes, and only that piece then needs to get uploaded or backed up or whatever. The bottom line there, of course, is that, yeah, your data is saved. You have a folder that's password protected in the sense that it needs to be mounted using Cryptomator, and you need to provide the correct passphrase. Once again, only you have access because only you know the correct passphrase. And specifically with Cryptomator, it's designed for online cloud services like Dropbox or OneDrive or any of a number of others, but you don't have to use them with that. You can, if you like, use Cryptomator to encrypt the files on a USB thumb drive or on a folder on your hard drive that has nothing to do with your cloud storage. It's a fine, fine encryption tool. But that really gives us the bottom line here. There really isn't an effective way to secure a folder in Windows using just Windows. Instead, what I recommend you look into are encryption tools. And the tools that probably make the most sense are VeraCrypt and Cryptomator. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2850. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.